Hey Greyhound fans, I'm Paul Cassaro here with another spring football report. Today I'm standing here with Brennan Williams, a senior wide receiver here for the Hounds. Brennan, the first question I have for you is, obviously the spring season is a time for your football team to really grow and get ready for the fall. As a member of the offense, what has most pleased you with the offense's progress so far this spring?
I'd have to say our young guys. We've got a lot of young guys stepping up, and R.C. Hauser and Reese Horn, they're stepping up and they're getting their job done. They're trying to learn the playbook as fast as they can, so I think that's helping us out a lot. I mean, we're taking big steps forward, being able to get these young guys incorporated into the offense.
Great. Well, obviously we have a big spring game this Saturday. Going into that game, how do you expect the offense to fare against the defense?
I think the offense is going to do a pretty good job, actually. We have a whole stable of backs. We have about four guys competing at running back. Wide receiver, we're doing pretty well. We're pretty well off there. And our quarterbacks are just battling it out. So I think the offense is going to handle the defense pretty well because we got a few tricks up our sleeve as well.
You're being kind of humble about it. Are you going to handle them pretty well, or are you guys going to beat them down pretty good?
We're probably going to destroy them.
That's what I thought. But now, you in the past, you've made some very big catches, some very big plays for our team over the last three seasons. But this year is really, people are expecting you to really have a breakout season this year and you'd have more of a featured role. What are your goals and expectations for yourself heading into this season?
Heading into this season, of course, like you said, I had the big plays. I'm just expecting myself to make those plays on a regular basis, not just third down situations, just all situations, all game long. I expect myself to be a leader for the offense and be able to be the go-to guy in that key time at the end of the game.
Good. Well, we're all hoping to see that as well. Rumor has it that you're quite the Twitter junkie. I hear that you spend quite a lot of time on Twitter, and there are some pretty entertaining tweets coming from you. How many tweets do you send out per day?
Oh, man, it ranges from 100 to 250 in a day. I mean, I just like to keep my followers entertained, you know, and I keep bringing the followers in. I'm around like 400 now, so I'm doing pretty well.
Well, good. Well, hopefully your play this fall will be as entertaining as your tweets are. Now I'm standing here with Javon Jordan, a senior defensive lineman for the Hounds. Javon, what has most impressed you with the defense this spring?
Most impressed me with defense this spring has probably been an improvement we had both on all levels of the defense, from the D-line to the linebacker to the secondary. Everybody progressed together, and everything's coming together. We're getting to run together, and everything's moving fluently.
Now, you mentioned the run. Is that an aspect that you guys were particularly focused on this spring?
I believe that was one of our number one goals this spring. Stopping the run, you have to stop the run in order to make teams pass against you. And we don't like people running on us, so we want to make sure that no one is allowed to run on our defense.
Now, what about this Saturday? Are you guys going to stop the run against our offense?
Our offense is a little tricky. They have some great talent on that side of the ball. They have some great blocking receivers, a great blocking interior linemen. They have some really good running backs, but we definitely going to stop the run against our own guys.
I had Brennan Williams on here a little bit ago, and he predicted that the offense was going to handle the defense. What do you have to say about that?
Brandon has always been like that, but it's going to be a tough battle. They have some good talent, but we have great talent on our side of the ball as well. We got a lot of good players, got a good guy stepping up and doing some great things for our defense. It should be a good match, but defense will come on top.
Good to hear. I'm glad that we have guys on both sides of the ball confident. Now, you're a guy who, over your career here, has played both interior and on the outside for the defensive line. What are the challenges of playing multiple positions on the D-line?
It's really just the technique. Our defense is a gap defense. We've been that since I've been here. Basically, it's just the technique. We want to rush the pass on third downs, but we want to stop the run on first and second. It's really just getting together, knowing your keys, attacking, and being physical.
Good to hear. Well, there has been addition to the coaching staff this year. Coach Gus, our defensive line coach, has got a new assistant, Coach Kincaid. And from what I hear, that he has a lot of personality and intensity that he brings to the field every day.
Oh, yeah. You'd ever come see us practice, you'd hear Kincaid hollering around, get ready, be ready, hop around, things like that. He's a fiery guy, and we need that on our team to fire up our defense, especially our D-line, getting us going, getting us together. We worked harder than we've ever worked before at this institution. So he's a great addition to us, and I look forward to seeing him during the season, hopefully.
Well, obviously everybody likes a lot of fire and enthusiasm. All the players I know have really enjoyed him so far. Do you have an impression of Coach Kincaid that you could do for me?
I'm around.
Awesome. All right, well, Greyhound fans, thanks for tuning in. I'm Paul Cassaro here with Javon Jordan, and be sure to tune in for one final spring update after the spring game.